Hello everyone, it's Elsie. Welcome to my channel. I make tutorials on how to use CapCut. So if you would like to see more of that, please consider like and subscribe as it would really help my channel. If you haven't noticed, with the most up-to-date version of CapCut, now you can use keyframe on audio, filter, text, and sticker. If you watch my video on how to use the keyframe function, you probably would know the basic of it. So this video will be how to use the keyframe function part 2. I will show you how you can use the keyframe function on audio, filter, text, and sticker. I will also show you some trick on how you can use the keyframe function on videos or photo. Now let's get started. As you can see here, I already have a video clip. Now I'm going to import the sound that I want to use for this video clip. So I would click on audio, extract, and then you click on the clip where you want to extract the audio from, import sound only. You might wonder, what can I use the keyframe function for? Well, you can use the keyframe function to adjust the volume. So to do that, you would click on the audio clip, click on the keyframe icon, and then let's say I want the volume of the beginning to be low. And then you would go to the next point. I want this part to be louder. So what that means is from keyframe 1 to keyframe 2, the sound will gradually become louder. And let me get to the next point. I want it to be lower here. So here's how it sounds like. Oh, you can hear the difference within the volume there. So that's how you can use the keyframe with the audio. Now let me show you how you can use the keyframe with filter. So you would go to filters. Then you would select the filter that you want to use. For demonstration purpose, I'm going to select one that's more obvious so you can see the change. So I'm going to select red. And you will adjust the filter to how long you want. Let's say I want the beginning to be more red, so I would click on the filter, click on the keyframe icon, and then I would go to the next spot. I don't want as much of the red filter here, so I click on the keyframe again, go to filters, and you can adjust here. And then you can go to the next spot. Let's say I want more of the red here again, then click on it, filters, and you adjust it. And you go to the next one, click on it, and you can adjust it again. So here's how it would look like. So that's how you can use the keyframe function with filters. Now let me show you how you can use the keyframe function with text. So you would click on text, add text, type in the text that you want to put. And then you can go to style to select different font if you want to. You can also select different colors. You can also change the color, stroke, background. With the newest version of CapCut, you can also make the letter into bold, italic, or underline if you want. You can also go to effects. There are a lot of different effects you can select. You can even add bubble to it if you want. You can also add an animation if you want. And you will adjust the text to how long you want it. Then you can click on the text, click on the keyframe. Let's say I want the text to be smaller. I can use two fingers to pinch in to make it smaller. And then I would go to the next keyframe. Add another icon to make it bigger. Then go to the next one. And you can even rotate the text. And then go to the next one and make it bigger. That's how the text would turn out. That's how you can use the keyframe with the text. Now let me show you how you can use keyframe with sticker. To use keyframe with stickers, you can click on stickers, select whichever one sticker that you like. If you don't like that, you can also go to the picture icon here. Then you can add in your own picture. You can import picture or GIF picture that are moving. So I'm going to select the Totoro here. Some of you see me using the Totoro at the bottom of my video as it walking across. So I'm going to show you how to do that. You would make sure the clip go all the way to the ending where you want. And then you would go to the beginning. You would click on the sticker. Click on the keyframe icon. And you would move it to the place where you want. So usually I have it all the way in. And then you move it all the way to the end. And you add in another keyframe. And you move it all the way across to the other end. This is how it would turn out. With sticker, you can also add in different animation if you want. So that's how you can use the keyframe function with stickers. Lastly, let me show you how you can use the keyframe function to rotate pictures or videos. In this case, I'm just going to use a picture as an example. So click on overlay, add overlay, add in the picture that you want to use. Click on the keyframe icon. Adjust it to the spot that you want. Let's say I want it here. Then you would go to the next spot. You can use two fingers to rotate the image. Or you can go to edit and you use the rotate function. Depends on how many times you want to do it, then you would rotate how many times. So I'm good with that. And then I would go to the next one. Another keyframe. I want it to be smaller, and then at another keyframe, I want it to be disappear. So I would go to opacity and I would select all the way to 0. So this is how it will turn out. That's how you can use the keyframe function with audio, filter, text, sticker, pictures, or videos. If you found my video to be helpful, please consider like and subscribe to support my channel. I hope you have a wonderful day and I will see you next time.